This is Barnes in southwest London, and it's a lovely little place. It's got a high street over there, it's got a village pond, it's got loads of independent shops, and it's also involved in an experiment to try and combine the best of its past with the best of its future. And at the heart of all of this is small-scale cargo transport via electric bikes, and not any electric bikes, but specialised electric cargo bikes, or e-cargo bikes. So that's the question for today. Can bicycle deliveries become again a part of the future, but in a scalable, battery-powered way? And could the e-cargo bike really do something to boost the British high street? Welcome to Fully Charged.
So over the last few years, we've been looking at what we can do to support our smaller independents, because we really don't want them to go. So looking at initiatives like a digital high street, you know, online shopping, how can we help our businesses have that presence on the internet so that they too can market what they have to sell to a much, much greater audience. So we've done a big campaign working with Save the High Street, looking at how we can support our businesses with their kind of digital strategies.
Tell us how the e-cargo bikes fit into this vision of the high street.
We have so many residents that want to be able to use our local shops, and for one reason or another, whether it's work or whatever, can't perhaps get into the high street on a daily basis. So the idea is about bringing those shops to them and enabling them to shop online for the things that they want from our independents. So with that concept, you then have to look at how you're going to deliver. And we don't want to clog up our now relatively uncongested streets, certainly in the village, with vans. So we looked at the e-cargo solution, and we partnered up with a company called Ginger Town, who have e-cargo bikes and riders, and our system has been working very well.
E-cargo bikes, they're really exciting. New innovation, they've been around for a little bit, but they're all part of the whole push to get better options than the big cars and vans that are on a street and congesting and making the air not so nice to breathe. And e-cargo bikes are sturdy bikes that have obviously electrically assisted, make it easy for people to get around.
So it is just electro assist, it's not electrically powered, you have to be pedaling.
You have to be pedaling and assist, and that's the way it is in the UK at the moment. But right. I think all of these things are going to evolve, and so you'll have your combination of whether they're bikes or they're just purely electric, which you will see. Mm-hmm. But it's really about small vehicles, clean, efficient vehicles, easy to get around, don't take up any more space on the road than they absolutely need to, easy to park, nice mm-hmm. to be out and around in. On our streets and
on a day when it's not raining.
On a day when it's not raining and nice and warm, that's right. So just a much better way and a much nicer way to get around.
Okay, so this is the beast.
Yep, this is the Tern GSD e-cargo bike.
There's a lot of it, isn't there? I mean, yeah. I hadn't been expecting so many bits everywhere.
Yeah, it's quite sturdy, it's quite strong.
That's the battery in the middle there, is it?
Yeah, it goes down into the motor and it's rear wheel.
So the motor's down here,
yep.
Rear wheel drive.
Yep, obviously pedal assisted. You've got the disc brakes here and back there
hidden
as well.
Under those are I have never seen panniers that big.
Oh yeah, I'll open one up for you. And they've just got these compartments here and they store a lot of stuff in there. Yeah.
So what kind of weight will this thing carry?
You could probably carry 150, 200 kg.
That's
quite a lot,
two
yeah.
or three people, yeah. depending on the people.
Depending on the people, yeah. And it is quite quick even with that weight.
So you get pedal assist up to 15 miles an hour?
15 miles, it cuts out about 16, 17. So that's how you turn it on, you've got your brakes. Bell.
And a little bell. What's funny about that is it's like innocent little bell
on
top of this thing. Now all of this is great in theory, but we want to see it in practice. So I'm going to follow along with one of the cargo bikes as it goes on a shopping trip. quite often with the big delivery companies, there are delivery charges and all that kind of thing. Is this an expensive system?
I don't think it's more expensive than the big deliveries. Of course, there are economies of scale in things, but you just have to work with the shops in order to make it efficient. And if you can make it efficient and you can get lots of deliveries going, and of course it's specific types of delivery, so it's hard to do somebody's weekly shop because it'll take up the whole bike.
Yeah.
And it'll take time to get it there. But if it's top-ups, or if it's, you know, if something where they're getting it from multiple shops, and it complements other services.
So perhaps this is a local baker or something that you might normally go to, and you only want one loaf of bread every couple of days or something. Yeah. It works for that. So is this the way to revive the high street?
Yeah, I think it's a big part of it, because it's one, it's making the high streets and the shops on the high streets more accessible to people, you know, whereas they might go online and be tempted to go for one of the big delivery services, they can now access and do that through their local shops. But one of the important things about high streets as well is just the environment, and just, you know, people like being out, being there. And one of the conundrums that high streets have is you want to allow people to access it, and therefore what's the trade-off between cycling and parking and these kinds of things. So if we can give more alternatives to be able to make it nicer for the footfall, but for people to access when they can't get to the high street, you get more business, makes it more sustainable, and helps those businesses.
How much space do you take up, and how is the sharing of the space work?
Well, it depends on the e-cargo bike you've got. We've got e-cargo bikes that are the same size as bicycles, they just have racks on the back. So just how you'd have a basket at the front, you've got a long square rectangle rack at the front that just makes the bike a little longer, so you're not really taking up that much more room, but you can get a lot more stuff on it than on a normal bike. I think it's just the way they're made, and when you're turning the handlebars, the rack doesn't move with you, so it's quite good. You're not bumping into things, and I get around on it quite quickly, and the drivers get around on it quite quickly, so it's a win-win.
Thing about crowded roads is they don't have very much space. The cars want space, the normal bikes want space, the e-bikes want space. How are we going to share all of this out? Well, to find out, I had a chat to someone from the London Cycling Campaign who've got a lot of opinions on all of this.
So if we have things like e-bikes and e-cargo bikes, what's the way forward here? Where do we put these things on the road?
All cities require a certain level of freight. I mean, freight is a big part of our lives. We can't do without food, we can't do without medical supplies. So we do need movement of freight, and the smaller and the more nimble and effective that freight is, the better. And cargo bikes are an opportunity for us to move some of the freight, some of the non-huge freight, in a quick, efficient and emission-free way. And that is really vital. And that's why we think that emission-free freight deliveries must be increased as rapidly as possible, so that we come down with the emissions in urban areas.
What's the attitude of the cyclists in general towards e-bikes and e-cargo bikes? Is there a bit of friction, or is that all just a myth?
You know, I think we know that we coexist, and we have to coexist. And by comparison to a 30-ton lorry, an e-cargo bike or an e-bike is not exactly a great threat. But on the other hand, you do need to consider that in such infrastructure as cycle tracks, then you might have to consider the largest cargo bikes. Perhaps they don't fit. I mean, it's simply a case of speed, mass and width. And if the vehicle that's going into the track is wider than the track, then obviously you have a problem. So there will be certain cases of cargo bikes which need to go in the road, and other ones which will go in the track. Ultimately, there's no reason why we shouldn't have tracks to cater for the larger cycles and the smaller cycles. I mean, we do have motorways which have, you know, 6 lanes, 8 lanes, even more lanes. So why shouldn't we have some lanes for cargo bike deliveries, other lanes for pedal cycles, and still other lanes, perhaps reduced lanes for motor vehicles?
So we're big believers in the future of shared transport. And one of the challenges of e-cargo bikes in particular is that they are very expensive. You know, they're big and expensive. So you've got to make quite a commitment. And for, you know, either whether it's a small business, that's a big commitment. And then you've got to change a little bit the way that you work, and you've got to have a place to store them. But also for you know, for a family to be able to access them, and you've got, so if you could have access to when you needed it, and you've got a vehicle that could be used by multiple people or businesses throughout the day, then we think then it becomes much more affordable for people and usable. So it's about building that critical mass of accessible e-cargo bikes and other vehicles that will then just create a sort of virtuous circle of usage and then build on that.
Someone always doesn't like change, and people want to do it in different ways. In practice, what are the obstacles? What do we need to do to make all of this work?
Well, during the epidemic or the pandemic, we've seen that there are a lot of people out there who are interested in cycling. Simply, they've done it. I mean, government statistics showed that cycling's doubled over the weekends. It's increased heavily during the week. So people want to cycle. There's no question of that. The thing is that they fear the danger of cars. So we really have to address the problem, which is that people aren't prepared to mix with cars to the extent that they're expected to. So we really do need better infrastructure for cycling, whether that's e-bike type cycling or cargo bike cycling or regular pedal cycling. We basically need the infrastructure, and the junctions also have to be addressed. So it really is about installing the facilities that make it possible for more people to cycle.
You've got almost a perfect setup for it here in Barnes. It's a very clearly defined little high street. It's got a local community. Everyone knows each other in there, I've noticed. What do you think Barnes is going to look like in 10 years' time?
We're very lucky because it's got a focal point, and so it is a very strong community, which we want to help build in every area. And of course, the high streets are fundamental to that. So if you can continue to improve the environment of the high streets and accessibility, then you know, we think that helps communities. And I think by this new technology, these smaller vehicles, of which e-cargo bikes and now e-scooters coming along and e-bikes and other things that are coming along, you get an environment of smaller vehicles. So if you can get a lot more use on these smaller vehicles, which are clean, nicer, create more space, then you know, we think it just helps build better, more livable streets.
Brilliant. I'm looking forward to this new world. It sounds fabulous. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
One of the things we've all been learning more about in lockdown is just the global supply chains that keep our society going. You know, there's ships and there's lorries and there's trains, and they're carrying these huge amounts of food all over the world to keep us fed. And I really like the idea that the last tiny bit of that journey, the last mile in a local tiny little village like this, could come via e-bike, via an e-cargo bike. And there's a huge amount of potential here to keep the local areas local, to reduce the number of cars on the streets, all of that stuff. I'm really impressed with the technology in this. I think it's a great way to get things around, but it's just human, and it's so nice that on the other end of that massive global logistics chain, there could just be a human being on a bike with a delivery. And I think that is a really nice thought. So I'm all for this. More cargo bikes, combining the high street, the e-bikes and the internet. It's a win. I'm in. And so that's it. That's all we've got time for. So if you'd like to support us, you can do that via Patreon or via YouTube membership. There's loads of stuff on the Fully Charged Show website, so go and have a look at all of that. And if you have been, thank you for watching.